Today we are going to start with intermediate botany first year. The first unit of first year, that is diversity in living world. First unit, diversity in living world. In this chapter we had discussing about general characters of living organism, comparison between living organism and non-living organism, and as well as how can we identify either it is living organism or non-living organism, and categories of living organism, classification of living organism, biological nomenclature, biological classification. These are the things we had discussed in this chapter. So first we had to talking about general characters of living organism. Living organism shows some different characters compared to non-living organisms. Living organisms generally, they are found in any places in the world, extreme hot conditions also, extreme cold conditions also. They can on the surface of the earth and in the air, in the underground, oceans, seas, rivers. So everything is found. Living organisms are present in everywhere in the world. So living organisms are found in on the earth, oceans, rivers and air, etc. So any place the living organisms are present, but the molecular structure is different. Either living organisms, I mean multicellular organisms and unicellular organisms. So mainly two types, huh? One is unicellular organisms. They are made up of only one cell. Living organisms, that is unicellular ones, they are mainly made up of only single cell. Next, multicellular organisms. These multicellular organisms are mainly made up of many cells, which is found. They have separate different types of body system, is the different types of functions they have to perform. Next, some general characters are shown by a living organism. So living organisms shows different kind of characters. One is growth. Next, respond to stimuli. And also shows reproduction. And cellular structure or arrangement. These are the characters are mainly shown by living organism. So these are the characters are mainly shown by living organisms. So first character we had to take, that is a growth. Growth is very important in the plant body, mainly. Growth, it means intrinsic growth, we have to consider here. Intrinsic growth. Or the growth is takes place in inside. It means growth in size increases, body mass increases, body size increases, body mass increases, and as well as how number of cells also here we have to consider. How many cells are produced? What is the body mass? What is the size of the body? Size of the body, increase the height or width, whatever it may be. So plant organisms are shows the size, increase the size, that is growth. Body mass increases, that is also growth. Number of cells are produced, that is also one type of growth. But what is the differences between living growth and non-living growth? In living growth, the growth is under comes into, I mean, started from the inside to out. And non-living, for example, in non-living things, mountains also will grow. That is also we are considered to growth. No, that is extrinsic growth, I mean, external growth. So mountains also will grow. It is not, we are not able to consider this thing. Why? Because mountains are grow, but externally, it means addition of substances, addition of rocks, addition of sand, water it may be, that is included. Materials are, they are added to increase the size of the mountain, but internally not. Living organisms height is increases, mass is increases, number of cells also reproduces. Why? Because the production, the increase the size and growth is done by internally. Internal growth is takes place in the living organism's body, and external growth is takes place in mountains growth. So growth is a not defining character. So growth is a not defining character. Yes, this is not defining character. We are not consider this is living organism, this is non-living organism with the help of growth. Why? Because mountains also will grow. That's why it is not a considerable character of living organism. So it is a growth is not a defined character. Next, respond to stimuli. Second one, respond to stimuli. Living organisms are respond to environment and their surroundings. So living organisms, they have consciousness towards the surroundings as well as an environment. Sense towards the environment. They have shows sense towards the environment. So it is shows sense towards environment. That stimuli mainly physically or chemically or biologically. So stimuli is different things. Stimuli, different type of stimuli. Either physical stimuli. So stimuli is physical stimuli and physical stimuli or chemical stimuli and biological stimuli. So living organisms are there respond to stimuli. When we keeps our hand on heated pan, immediately we are removed that hand from the pan. Why? Because we have some sense organs are working in our body. That's why we are removed that hand from the pan. This living organism, they cannot able to move that body because there is no particular response to them. So in living organisms, sense organs are not working and they are not respond to any stimuli. So non-living things not respond to stimuli. In coma patient, one exception is there. In coma patients in coma, they are not a response to any external stimuli. So patients in coma coma condition, not respond. They are not respond. So response to stimuli, it is also one type of defining character of living organisms. Next, reproduction. Different types of organisms are then they can able to prepare, they can able to produce their offspring similar to them. So organisms are produces same kind of offspring, that is reproduction. In the living organism's body, they can able to produce new offspring in their body similar to them, that is reproduction. This reproduction mainly different types of organisms shows different kind of methods of reproduction. In bacteria and hydra mainly they shows budding. Algae, they are mainly shown by fragmentation. Fungi shown by spore formation. Mosses and they are formation of different types of organisms shows different kind of methods of reproduction. And non-living organisms, they cannot able to reproduce. But in some situations, for example, mule is a organism which is crossed with donkey and horse. That is a crossed with this offspring of donkey and horse, which is the mule does not reproduce, which is a sterile. This organism actually sterile organism. Why? Because they cannot able to reproduce offsprings in their lifetime, that's why it is a sterile offspring. And worker bees also, they cannot able to involved in reproduction, they are not involved in reproduction. So workers also not like that. And infertile male and female in humans, infertile humans also, they cannot able to produce new offsprings in their lifetime. So these are the mule, they cannot able to produce new offspring by it is a living organism. And worker bees also living organism, but they cannot able to produce new organism in their lifetime. Human beings also living organism, but infertile human beings, they cannot able to produce new organisms in their lifetime. So these are the reproduction is a not a defining character. So conclusion, reproduction is not a defining character of living organisms. So reproduction also, it is not a defining character. Why? Because living organisms, but they cannot able to produce new offsprings in their lifetime. Next, metabolism. Metabolism. Living organisms mainly shows metabolic activities in their body. The living organism's body is mainly made up of organic compounds. So these organic compounds are produced in one particular way, can they can able to change in their body. So these organic compounds are biochemicals. They are produced in the body a particular quantity. They can able to change this into different forms. So metabolism mainly shown by living organism in two forms. One is catabolism, comma anabolism. Catabolism, big molecules are changes into small molecules, means that is catabolism. Catabolism means here big molecules are changes into small molecules. Small molecules, big molecules are changes into small molecules, that is catabolism. Catabolism. Next, small molecules are changes into big molecules. Small molecules are changes into big molecules, that is anabolism. That is biochemical reactions it is mainly. So these are mainly biochemical reactions. So this is the metabolism is a biochemical reactions. Biochemical reactions. These biochemical reactions means different compounds are changes into different in way. It means large compounds are changes into small compounds, small compounds are changes into big compounds. There is interconversion, changes into molecular structure. The chemical type of the chemical chemical reactions, biochemical reactions that takes place in the metabolism. That's why it is a biochemical reaction. These biochemical reactions changes into takes place. These biochemical reactions are not takes place in non-living things. Non-living things are like rocks, sand, mountains, whatever it may be. They cannot able to show biochemical reactions in their body. For example, glucose breakdowns into energy, release water and oxygen, and also releases carbon dioxide and water as well as energy. That is catabolic process. Glucose synthesis is the anabolic process. Glucose synthesis by the process of photosynthesis is the anabolic process. That glucose breakdowns into release energy, that is catabolic reaction. So here molecular structure will change completely. So that is metabolism. These photosynthesis and respiration type of kind of metabolic activities are not there in non-living organisms. So metabolic activities only shown by living organisms only. Next, some exceptions, I mean not exceptions like that. Isolated compounds, they can able to change. Isolated compounds, comma, in vitro fertilization, in vitro methods. Like in vitro fertilization, the living organisms are produced in that test tube. So it is a one type of biochemical reaction, it is a one type of metabolism, but it is not takes place in inside the living organism's body. But reactions are takes place similar to living organism's body, but that reactions are not takes place inside of the body, they are takes place in outside of the body. That is in vitro methods. Isolated substances, any substances we have to isolate from the plant body or animal body, that is works like a similar to living organism's body in test tube, but it is not a exact metabolism. So metabolism also it is a defining character. Next, last one, cellular structure is a one kind of defining character of living organism. Why? Because different cells is there. In unicellular organism, only one cell is present. In multicellular organism, many cells are present. In unicellular organism, made by only one cell, and multicellular organism, it is mainly made up of more than one cell. More than one cells are present in the multicellular organism. Unicellular one mainly only made up of only one cell, but multicellular ones are made up of many cells. It is cellular structure is a one type of defining character of living organism. It is a defining character of living organism. Why? Because these cellular structures are not present in the non-living things like air and whatever it may be, sand, rocks. They cannot able to show multicellular and unicellular type of kind of nature. So particular cellular structure not there in non-living things. Cellular structure present in living organism, either unicellular or multicellular. It is a defining character of living organisms. So these are the different types of defining character of living organisms. These are, we have to use these type of, these kind of points to understand either it is living organism or non-living organism. So growth, next respond to stimuli, reproduction, metabolism, cellular structure.